just a much better session.
Hi everybody, welcome to season. I'd just like to thank you all for coming out. Very exciting day we're going to have today. It's our kickoff for the season. We're heading into two different seasons. We're heading into junior program. We're also heading into the ladies league season. Some of the ladies on the teams are out here. We've been doing extremely well. So we're very happy that that's been going on and going so well. Today is our big announcement that Seasons is officially a Johan Kriek, who hopefully you all got to meet, a former Australian Open two-time champion, 14 ATP Tour finals.
How did that happen?
We are opening up a Top Gun Junior Academy here at Seasons, and Johan will be teaching the kids. And we'll be partaking. We will be working on mental toughness, nutrition, videos, everything full on. Let's get the kids really pumped up, really coached well. And in case you didn't notice, some of these little kids who are hitting on this court, you'll get to see some of them later. Amazing. His son and daughter, amazing players. So it's very exciting that we're able to do this and bring it to Boca. He will help a little bit with the adults too now and then, I'm sure. So we'll get to see.
Just for my sanity.
Today what we're going to do is we're just going to have a fun day today. It's just about hitting balls, having fun, being able to turn around afterwards and say, hey, I got to hit balls this day, Australian Open winner. Every one of you will get a chance to hit some balls back and forth with us. We're going to do that on this court over here, where we're going to be dividing. We're going to hit balls back and forth on this court. On court three, you're going to be with BJ. BJ, raise your hand. Right, BJ, our head pro here at Seasons. Yay! So BJ's going to be running you through a bunch of different drills on court three. Just move around, hit them all, shake them, move them, do whatever. It's going to be fun. Then you're going to be going to court five, back in the corner, with my handsome son, Alexander, right there. Alex is going to be doing radar, fast serve. We've got a prize for the biggest serve. Right now, so far today, standing 96 right here.
No, that's not fair.
What did I get?
45. 96 kilometers.
Right? 96 kilometers. So we're going to have an adult's fast serve and a kid's fast serve, so there's fair for everybody. Okay? So that's a fast serve speed court there. At the back over here on 7 and 8, you're going to be going through some fun game stuff with Dina. Raise your hand, Dina. We all know Dina, our social director. Dina is going to be doing a lot of fun games with you and with the kids and so forth. And joining her is Andre, who is right here. He is another South African. So we welcome him, just a new transplant here. Top 30 in the country in South Africa, top 30 on the continent before he moved here. Teaches up at the academy as well in Jupiter, where Johan has a second academy. We're trying to turn this into a satellite and put the academies all over the place so we can have good, strong tennis. And then we have Athena. Everybody welcome Athena. Athena has joined our crew over here at Seasons. She will be helping us with our junior program in the afternoons, helping when we need at the academy, as BJ and I will as well, and is also doing the ladies' teams. Athena's court is going to be on court four, and her court is going to be just easy, nice drills, calm, relaxed. A little warm down, it'll get yourself ready to go to courts, five grade off, or calm down after you've come off BJ's offense defense court, because BJ's going to be high intensity. And then what we're going to do for the last 15-20 minutes is we're very lucky. I don't know if any of you know, we have Jonathan Schneider. Wave your hand. Jonathan Schneider is our resident here. He was 1,000 in the world. He's an ATP player as well, journeyman player. So Jonathan will be teaming up with Daniel Vardag, or with Johan, or Daniel Vardag. Where's Daniel?
He's gonna carry you.
Where's Daniel? Daniel Vardeg, who's down there, who maybe some of you know. Daniel is our resident Doris Vardeg's son. Daniel played, there's Daniel there. Wave, Dan. Daniel, wave. And that's his mom, Doris, who lives here. Daniel played number one singles for FAU. Baller, let me tell you, big time tennis head. So we're going to do a little exhibition doubles. For the last 15 minutes, we have bagels, we have water, we have Gatorade in the coolers. Please make sure you stay hydrated. Once again, please welcome your hungry.
South Africa on a farm of 500 people, didn't speak English at all until I was about 18 years old. I spoke Afrikaans and I spoke Zulu. So if somebody had said to me, you know, your two cement courts are going to be your foundation in a tiny town, and one day you're going to be playing on all four Grand Slam facilities and you're going to win two majors, I would have thought they were smoking something. But this is what happens when you have a kid that is absolutely besotted about a sport. And what happens when that seed is grown and they discovered me at age 10 and they say, he's got to get out of Pongola, South Africa. He's got to go to Pretoria. I went to the school. I went to boarding school and my tennis blossomed. And I mean, I've had an unbelievable career. I can't tell you how lucky I was. I got to be number 7 in the world. I beat John McEnroe, Bjorn Borg, Connors, all these guys in my era. And here I am coaching tennis. So my passion for the sport and my passion from my wife's side has never left us. Tennis has been our whole life. We're on this journey with these two little guys. Who knows what's going to happen? You know, seen it all. I've seen it all. Gone through a lot of stuff. But for me, it's a pleasure to be here. I'm a Florida boy. I've lived in Naples, Florida 37 years. I've been living out in Palm Beach Gardens for the last 7. I met him by pure chance a few weeks ago and we started talking. And look what happened. Look what happened. I tell you what. This sport of tennis is the most wonderful sport to teach your kids life skills. Life skills. Because in that hour and a half, you're going to be happy. You're going to be tired. You're going to be elated. You're going to be disappointed. You're going to be disappointed in yourself. You're going to doubt yourself. And if you just teach them these tools of how to stick with it, how to fight, how to think, how to overcome obstacles, how to play a guy that's massive or a kid that's twice your size. I was always, one of my proudest moments as a junior was when I play a guy that's 3 times my size and I'm holding this gigantic trophy and he's got this little runner-up thing. That picture to me was more inspiration than anything else. And pretty soon, you guys are going to start getting your, quote, street credit because you are beating people. People start to notice. Other kids start to notice. People start to talk. I know UTR and all this fancy stuff on computers now, it drives me nuts. But it is today. It's what it is today with technology. But when you start to get that street credit, that's what you want. You want that sauce to be already on the court. You walk out on the court and the other kid goes, oh my God, this kid never gets tired. He plays at 12 o'clock in the middle of the day in summer in Florida. He never runs out of gas. That's street credit. That's something that's a pressure already on the other person. So we're going to go through a lot of stuff over the next few months and years with fitness. And we work with fitness on the court. A 10-year-old doesn't need to be on the gym. Unless he's 6'6", and then I don't trust your damn boots. Okay? So we gotta be on the tennis court. We can be off the court and fun stuff. And, you know, we keep it fun. We work hard. We keep it fun. We keep the kids inspired. And who knows who pops out and who goes somewhere? You know, everybody has different reasons why they play tennis. My first reason was always I was nuts about the sport. I loved it. I slept with my racket. I played with this tennis ball till there's no fuzz on it. That's the kind of want I would like to try and instill in you guys. And that's why I'm still at age 64, not too bad shape. You know, I still have the passion for the sport. And I hope I can instill some of that. But if you want to talk to the really smart person, this is my wife, Daga. She's going to be roaming. And she's the one that runs my whole business with me. So she's incredibly good at this. And she knows a lot about tennis, played G1 tennis. Got 2 degrees out of her college. Come from little Poland. Via Germany to America, got 2 degrees, went to American University, got her master's in PR. She's a smart one.
If you have any questions, you can ask me. I'm sure I'm not going to have all the answers.
No, he says, oh, I don't want to think that.
it's a journey.
Just make them, keep them maybe once a week. See, because honestly, and you can tell, the two of us, we're up playing tennis, and you can tell we put our kids at tennis. Because honestly, if you ask me, I don't think they're the best sport. Honestly. This is a wonderful sport for life. I don't play professional. I went to get my full scholarship for Virginia Tech. I ended up getting my master's degree for free because I was coaching at the American University. I was the assistant coach for the college team. So I didn't pay a penny. I got my master's degree here in the United States. So anyways, I have flyers. I'm passing around. It has my cell phone number on it. The best way to reach me is text me. Please text me on the number. Because I have so many messages coming, make sure you put your name, the kid's name and ages next to it, so I know. And then maybe put a beginner, intermediate, tournament player. You know, the UTR, for the UTR, I know the UTR system because of these two. So, and that's it. And I will get back to you, for sure. I'll get back to everyone. So please, I'm Daga. I will pass around the flyers. If you have any questions, ask, please. Thank you.
Any questions? Very smart people. Unbelievable.
You seem at home on the court.
Let's say that I've played around.
Well, you don't look like the sort.
My hidden talents abound. A competitor hasn't been found to defeat me.
I bet you're a real good sport.
Shall we say the ball is in your court?
I bet you like to play rough.
I like to work up a sweat.
And you just can't get enough.
I'm good for more than one set. But I promise I'll show no regret if you beat me.
My backhand is clearly my forte.
Shall we say the ball is in your court?
Your next of kin did.
My husband never plays with me. He's too easily winded.
You leave me breathless too.
Wait till our match is through.
I may lack form and finesse, but I warm up in a jiff.
It's not exciting unless the competition is stiff.
I think I understand your racket. I'm not in your league,
but you can hack it.
This game commences with love.
Well, I think love is a bore.
Let's give the tempo a shove
and raise the stakes a bit more.
One thing I'm positive of, it's time for someone to score. Tell me how you like to play.
On grass or clay, and every day.
They're both okay. Rally.
Shall we say the ball is in your court?
Thank you.
None of this would have happened. So thank you very much for everybody coming out. Thank you so much.